went to the mayor and we had young people in this conversation, and they were supposed to be heard in relation to what school safety looks like for them. And the words that were being said fell upon deaf ears. So we took it upon ourselves to have our own youth-led town hall where the youth lead the conversation and dominate and dictate what the mayor needs to do in relation to our young people.
Lack of guidance counselors in schools can lead to tragedies such as bullying, physical violence, and in worst case, suicide and other life-threatening actions. We want to see more guidance counselors in our schools and less cops. We need advisors, counselors, social workers to tackle this issue on mental health from within the school before it escalates and prompts a tragedy.
We know that suspension prevents students from engaging in one-on-one time with teachers, interacting with their peers, and many other things that can set them behind. Many of my peers and black and brown students across the city have experienced harsh disciplines, suspensions, and detentions that push them into the school-to-prison pipeline. This must end now.
In my 4 years of being a New York City public high school student, I never once learned about a single person from my culture. I want a curriculum that celebrates my heritage and other people's heritage, that doesn't whitewash.
Restorative justice is an alternative to suspensions and arrests. It provides safe space for youth who are harmed or have caused harm to have a chance to repair their relationships and address the harm that was created.
Detectors and cops, a topic that we as youth have always come to face, and we would always want less of in our schools, but it comes to one thing, and it's always that our voices are not heard about this topic. How is it that people are targeted, whether it's Black, Latinx, LGBTQIA,